What to do if you get negative results from a subliminal? There's been a lot of drama in the community lately and a lot of fear. I decided to make this video to give people some real information. But at the end of the day, these are just my thoughts and I'm going to be sharing my experience. I'm open to discuss and learn more. I will be talking about the law of attraction here. I don't know if you believe in it, but this should still be informative even if you don't. Here's some symptoms of negative subliminals. OMG, just typing this out gives me the creeps, lol, help. Acting out of character in a negative way, sudden fatigue, nightmares, irrational fear or anger, sorrow, strange accidents happening to you, fear and anxiety, ongoing bad luck, becoming paranoid, sudden depression without a cause, a feeling that you're being watched, etc., etc. Now, let's get started. 1. Is it detox or subliminal with bad intentions? Detox is the idea that when you start listening to a subliminal, your old negative thoughts start being flushed to the surface to be replaced and transformed. I'm a complete believer in this and have experienced it myself. I listened to a glow-up subliminal I made myself before going to sleep, and after a while I started feeling so much guilt that I was legit turning around in my bed and feeling like the worst, most horrible person in the whole world. The subliminal had a lot of self-love affirmations, so how could this be happening? When I started questioning why am I feeling this way, I found out it was because I grew up with a narcissistic mother, and whenever I would try doing something for myself I would be called selfish or a brat. This belief that if I show love to myself I am being selfish was getting in the way of the glow up, so it had to go. Whatever is getting in the way is going to be flushed to the surface to be replaced. The general rule is that a lower vibration cannot share space with a higher one. So before jumping to a conclusion if this is an actual bad subliminal, we need to question where these feelings could be coming from. But generally the difference is that you're consistently getting bad results after multiple listens even though you've done your questioning. Also, other people will probably experience something similar and you will be able to read about it in the comments. 2. Become aware. The second you become aware of your emotions behaviors, these negative affirmations start losing momentum because they're no longer roaming free in the back of your mind. If you're aware, you're not on autopilot and you start taking action more consciously. The second these ifs lose energy, they don't have a grip on you anymore, and from there you can start shifting your focus to taking care of yourself. This should really empower you because this means that at the end of the day, no one can control where you put your focus and energy. People can influence you but they cannot take away choice. 2. Neutralizing negative energy. Cleanse, cleanse, cleanse. Take a shower. The energy of water is one of the highest vibrations on Earth. Water is naturally cleansing and it also holds a lot of symbolism to our mind. We usually shower in the morning so it can help you reset your mind and symbolize a new beginning. You can also use sage, burn sage through your auric field, or use sage essential oil. 3. Crystals. This is optional and I don't know if you're into crystals, but try carrying them to protect from any unforeseen side effects these MFS had in mind. In my opinion the best one is tiger's eye because it reveals danger before it happens. You can also use black tourmaline, obsidian or maldavite. 4. Validate yourself. You maybe didn't end up here intentionally, but it's still your emotions. You need to treat them as real. If you're feeling anxious, for example, you still need to help yourself calm down. Please don't abandon yourself. From there you can do a visualization. Your mind doesn't tell a difference between what's real and what's not. It's the reason subliminals work in the first place. To use an aggressive example, if you closed your eyes and imagined almost getting hit by a car, you would have a reaction as if it was real, your heart would start pounding and you would experience fear. Use this to your advantage. Start visualizing anything that helps you feel safe. This is an individual process, so there is no right or wrong way of doing this. Use intuition. Here's some ideas. Maybe what makes you feel safe is a feeling of nothing being able to touch you, so you can imagine an energetic wall around yourself where nothing can come in without your permission. From there you can ask yourself what do you need to feel better and visualize giving that to the part of yourself that needs it. It can be anything, this is your imagination so there is no limit. You can also imagine pulling out negativity from your mind and imagine universe taking it away, then replacing it with white light. 5. Write about it. Identify the subliminal, stop listening to it and write about your experience in the comments. Please write respectfully and responsibly. Unless you are actually able to hear the negative affirmations, don't jump to conclusions. You never know why the sub is bad. Maybe the creator didn't have bad intentions, it's just that they were using ineffective affirmations unknowingly. In general, a good submaker wants their subs to actually work and will be open to criticism and changing their affirmations to more effective ones. Please still be respectful, we don't need more drama. 6. What can I do long term to keep safe from bad subs? Get into a habit of after listening to a new subliminal you pause for a minute and notice how you feel. Do you feel light? Heavy? Better or worse? Any discomfort? Try to just observe your state. Also listen to your intuition, it is always speaking to you. The best way to do this is to notice how you feel in your heart. Your intuition will always feel like just information without a lot of emotional attachment. If it comes with a lot of fear and loudness, it's probably just ego. Intuition doesn't have to fight for your attention. And to be honest, a lot of drama that's been going on in the community lately felt very loud. 7. Some hope. If you ever made a subliminal ever, you realize how powerful writing our affirmations is, especially if you're in the flow and been doing it for an hour or more. You completely take on the energy of your affirmations and a lot of submakers experience results during the making of the subliminal. Those people writing bad subliminals are not an exception to this. You can't put out negative energy without in training with it and eventually receiving it back. So ironically enough, this is the reason they all get caught. They are creating their own fall simply because the universe always brings back what you put out. The reality is that we don't know how painful their lives are. So we can relax a little, it is a vibrational impossibility that they aren't caught one way or the other. The law of cause and effect will take care of it for us.